Sir, so far I think you've been talking about ads in the direct sense of the word. Ibig sabihin talagang harapan na garapala na ads, na advertisements na vote for so and so and so. But I suppose a big chunk of the expenses and as well a big chunk of the following is not with regard to ads but to the softer sell of using, for example, so-called influencers or so third-party people who may not necessarily have an obvious direct line or direct link with candidates. How can we monitor and regulate that kind of spending and that kind of advertising?
Well, if you're an influencer who's really pushing for a particular candidate, you will of course be required to submit your contract and your receipts. No, that will be for those that are obviously in a contractual relationship. Doon naman sa mga hindi sila obvious na merong contractual relationship, mga taong hindi mo alam kung bayad o hindi. What the COMELEC does is it really observes the behavior of these websites to see if there is a pattern of campaigning for a particular candidate, no? And then that might be called into question whether or not those services have to be paid for. But again, this is all monitoring after the fact.
Yes, sir. But isn't that a bit of a gray line? Kasi a person can always claim na hindi mo ako binayaran, talagang true believer ako. And I suppose that is going to be used a lot. That kind of argument is going to be used a lot.
That's expected. And you're right. It is a gray line. But then again, you do remember that there is no law existing right now. And COMELEC cannot conjure up a law out of thin air. We can only operate within the authorities that's available to us right now.